Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the exciting new stuff that has come to Affinity Designer 2.5. I have prepared something because you all know how to do that. So I've got all these shapes that I've drawn using the shape tools in Affinity Designer, and let's just scale them. And in order to scale them, you can select all of them and then scale them. So, but when we're doing this in this way, then all we have is the bounding box, and then we can drag that. I'm going to undo that. Now, there's this interesting function that you can also scale them separately. So it's up here. You have to turn that on, transform object separately. And when we then scale them, then you see they are all scaled proportionally in proportion to the one that is selected here. And you can also do that numerically. So you go to Window Transform, and then you can enter the size. But when you do that, they are scaled proportionally. So what's new is that you can all scale them to a specific size, and that is kind of complicated to enter. So what you need to do is, of course, set up in this symbol from where you want to scale them. Currently, it's the top left. You can also set it to the center, and then you need to enter that size. So if you want them to be 30 by 30 millimeters, then what you have to enter is equal 30 millimeters, and then of course down here, and then let's see, now it's turned on, now it's turned off again, equal 30 millimeters, and then you have scaled them all to 30 millimeters each. That's nice. I like that functionality. Let's get on to the next thing. And for that, I have prepared this curve, just drawn with the pencil tool, and then you can apply a variable width to it. So you go up here into the stroke attributes, and then you can increase the width. And you can also go in here into the pressure, and then you can enter that pressure marks like that, and then you can have it in variable width. But what's new is that there is a tool for that. You have this tool here, and you see there are additional controls. Let's turn them off first, and you see what you have set up in the stroke panel is now a control here, and you can just click and drag to have this variable width, and you can also introduce new ones by clicking and dragging. And you can also move them around and increase and decrease them. You can double click them and then they are gone, just like that, just like so. And that again is reflected in the strokes panel. And then let's take a look at these options. So we can snap them. You can snap them to width on the same curve. So turn that on, and then everything snaps to everything else. Now you see it has snapped to the next one that is in magenta, or to that one, just like so. The next snapping snaps to the curve nodes. Now they are independent from the nodes on the curve, but you can snap them to them. So now it snaps to this node if you need that. Next, you can also lock them. So you can lock the line weight. And when you now try to make one larger than the line weight, that is not possible. You can make it smaller, but not larger. And this one is also interesting, the point ordering, which locks the order in which the width points are set. So usually, let's turn that off again, when moving them, you can move them past each other. When you turn that on, that is no longer possible. So now it snaps here, and you have this interesting kind of width, which you might need as well. Maybe that's this stroke width tool. So now let's take a look at text. Let's make some space here, like this. and let's set them text. So let's just stay with this here, and I'm going to enlarge it like so, like this, and then let's go to the options. So I've downloaded a variable font. So it's this one here. And then you see when you have a variable font, which Affinity Designer now can work with, then you get this additional control, those variation settings, and then you can manipulate the axes of the variable font. And whatever is built into the font, here's the softness and the wonkiness, just like this, and you can work with that. There's another thing. We have those shapes, and down there in the shapes is a QR code tool. And you can take that and drag a QR code like this. And then when you have set it up, let's see that we can get it without a stroke. And then we have this input here. You can click on that, and then you can choose the type of the QR code that you want to have, and then input whatever you need for it and set up your QR code in Affinity Designer. So those are the interesting new functions it has got. There are more functions, but those are the ones I find pretty interesting and nice.